call Miss Gilmore. I don't want her to know about it. Did she hurt you? She tried to, didn't she? Oh, Toto, she's the meanest old woman there ever was. Let's go tell Uncle Henry and Auntie Anne. They'll do something about it. Come on, Toto.
You see, this old incubator's gone bad, and we're likely to lose a lot of our chicks.
Oh, the poor little things. Oh, Banana, Miss Gulch has told him back in the break just because she says he gets in her garden and chases her nasty old cat every day.
Dorothy, please!
Oh, but he doesn't do it every day, just once or twice a week. And he can't catch her old cat anyway. And now she says,
Dorothy, we're busy.
Uncle Henry, can't you do something?
I'm going to do something right now, honey. So can you please just stay out of our hair?
Oh, all right.
Whose idea was it to move the wagon before the fourth wheel was on?
Well, it doesn't weigh as much as one wheel left. That makes sense, don't it?
Sense or no sense, when I lift up the axe, you can stop her up.
Zeke, Hickory, no Miss Gulch did the Toto?
I swear that made this new wheel smaller than the other three.
She tried to kill him.
Oh, bigger, smaller, shut her out of my arms. Clear out of the sockets. I ain't a statue, though. I ain't made of iron.
Okay, okay.
Why won't anybody listen? Don't you care about Toto?
Ow! You got my finger!
Hunk, what am I gonna do about Miss Gulch just because Toto chases her old cat?
Dorothy, you're not using your head about Miss Gulch. Ain't you got any brains?
Sure I have brains.
Then why don't you use them? When you go home, don't go by Miss Gulch's place. Then Toto won't get in her garden and you won't get in any trouble, see?
Hey! We're just standing around to clear the junk out of that wagon. We gotta pause some lumber all the time before the weather turns.
We'll do, Mr. Gamble.
Zeke, what am I gonna do?
Well, for a start, kid, don't let that old gulch help her dry and buffalo you. She ain't nothing to be afraid of. Gotta stand up for her, show a little courage, a little grit.
We're not afraid of her.
That's what I wanted to hear. Put your chest out, your head up. The next time she squawks, you just stroll right up to her and spit in her eye. That's what I'd do.
Would you really?
Sure I would. This life, gotta walk tall, shoot straight, then you got no reason to be afraid of nothing and nobody. Back
off! Zeke, are you all right?
What are you trying to do? Kill a cat?
How could you two be so cruel?
Oh, it was just a red dog.
Can't you see how mighty he is? You really scared him.
I was scared.
Oh, you were scared. If you was a jackrabbit, you'd be the next counter by now.
Here, with all this jabber, and there's work to be done.
Oh,
I know three shiftless farmhands. You have a job before they know.
Oh, it's just that little fun, Mrs. Gamble.
Oh, a farm's no place for fun. You want fun, go join the circus.
Might just do that. And be a strong man. See the world.
But I'll start posing for it now. Well, camera hands to stomach. Have some cookies.
Gosh, Mrs. Gamble.
Just baked.
Thanks.
Well, sit down, Chief. Get that wagon hitched up and see if you can go feed those hogs before they wear themselves into anemia.
Yes, ma'am.
Anna, really? You know Miss Gulch said she was going to do Toto? She said she was...
Dorothy, stop imagining things. You always get yourself into a fret over nothing.
Well...
Now, you just help us out for today and find yourself a place where you won't get into any trouble.
A place where there isn't any trouble. You suppose there's such a place, Toto? There must be. It's not a place you can get to by boat or train. It's far, far away. Behind the moon, beyond the rain. When all the world is a hopeless jumble and the raindrops tumble. Thank you.
done.
What she done? I'm all but laying for that bite on my leg.
You mean she bit you?
No! Her dog!
Okay, so she bit her dog.
After being Miss Gulch, I just made a fresh batch of cookies if you mind to sit for a while.
I'm afraid I have no appetite, Mrs. Gale. Indeed, I'm so shaken by that vicious attack by your niece's ferocious dog. I may never eat again.
But if you don't eat, then you waste away. And I hate to see you dwindle.
Dorothy, could you bring Chenango here a minute? I'm sure if Dorothy's upset you in any way, she'll be too glad to apologize as best she can.
It's gone beyond apologies, Mrs. Gale. I have laid an official complaint for the county sheriff.
Was he sober?
Dorothy, the sculpture seems very upset.
That dog is a menace to the community. That's not true. As an act of public service, young woman, I am to be here for the sheriff to see that he is destroyed.
Destroyed? Toto? Oh, but you can't. You mustn't. Uncle Henry, Annie, you won't let her, will you?
Of course I won't. Will you?
Oh, please, Annie. Toto didn't mean to. He didn't know he was doing anything wrong. I'm the one that ought to be punished. You can send him to bed without supper.
You hear how sorry the child is. Surely if she gives you a place of wide berth,
if you don't hand that dog over right now, I'll bring up a damage suit that'll take your whole farm. There's laws protecting folks against dogs that bite.
Well, how would it be if she keeps him tied up? He's really gentle. With gentle folk, that is.
Well, that's for the sheriff to decide. Here's an order allowing you to take him unless you want to go against the law.
Well, what's it say, Henry?
Exactly what she says. You gotta hand him over, Dorothy.
No, it won't let you!
You can't go against the law, Dorothy. I'm afraid poor Toto will have to go.
Now you're seeing reason. Here's what I'm taking him in. So you won't attack me again.
No, no, no! No!
Dorothy!
You go away. I'll bite myself! You wicked old witch. Uncle Henry, Annie, please don't let him take Toto. Please don't let him take him. Stop!
Ah!
It's no use running, Dorothy.
Hickory, I thought you were my friend.
Oh, he is your friend. We all are.
You can't fight the law, honey. Some things are bigger than all of us.
Let me have it, Dorothy.
Oh, no.
Oh, just put it in the basket.
That's more like it. Oh, Toto! That's more like it.
Oh, my gulch. Just because you own half the county doesn't mean you have the power to run the rest of us. For 23 years, I've been dying to tell you what I thought of you. You're right. Well, being a Christian woman, I can't say.
Oh, well, I can. So if you don't want to hear it, then you better pat on your pockets off of my land.
I don't take kind of that kind of talk, Henry Gale. Just you, remember. I have friends in high places.
And why don't you go climb on your broomstick and visit them? Hey! Did you got those horses you stuck to the wagon that time?
Nearly!
Eight? Good enough. Scars get darker every minute. Stop! Stop!
Well, come inside, Jordan.
No! I'm not going anywhere with you. If you really loved me, why you wouldn't have let Toto go?
Dorothy's getting orders from the sheriff. What do you expect us to do? Wave a wand and make it disappear?
Well, you still could have at least tried.
Oh.
You stood there like you were stuffed or something.
Oh, well, I just couldn't think of anything.
I'm sorry.
One mean old woman and you were scared of her?
It wasn't my place to interfere.
And you? You were worst of all. You stopped Toto from getting away. I just hate you.
Well, don't say that, Dorothy. You make me feel terrible inside, like my heart was all tore up.
I don't care. I never want to see any of you ever, ever again. Toto was the only friend I had in the whole world. And now I got no one to talk to, no one to play with. Well, I'll never see him again as long as I live. Toto! Oh, Toto!
Came back.
We'll have to run away. Let's see. We'll need food for me and a bone for you. And then we'll have to get far, far away from here. And we can't ever come back.
Says on the side of my conveyance?
Oh, please, Professor, why can't we go with you to see all the great crown heads of Europe?
Do you know any? Oh, you mean the thing. Well, I never do anything without consulting my crystal first. Why don't you sit right here for a minute while I conjure up out of air? Out of magical thin air. This very same genuine magic, authentic crystal used during the days of the priests of Isis and Osiris. During the days of the pharaohs of Egypt, when Cleopatra first saw the approach of Mark Antony and Julius Caesar, and so on and so on and so on. Why don't you close your eyes now and help me gaze into the infinite? We can't do these things without gazing into the infinite now, can we? No, we're getting pretty close now. Yes, we're almost there. Let's see. Why don't you open your eyes now and help me gaze into the crystal? Why, what's this? I see a house with a picket fence.
That's our farm.
And I see a woman. Her face is very careworn, and she's wearing a polka dot dress.
That's Anne.
Her name is Emily, right?
Yes, that's right. Well, what's she doing?
Why, it looks like she's crying.
Oh?
Someone must have hurt her. Someone must have broken her heart.
Well, why would anyone do that?
I don't know, but it's someone she loves very much. Someone she's taken care of in sickness.
Well, I had the measles once. Huh? And she stayed right by me every minute. But that was when I was very small. She doesn't care about me at all now.
Oh, I don't see that in the crystal.
They were going to kill Toto, and she did nothing to stop them.
I see none of that in the crystal. All I see is someone who loves you very much and misses you something terrible.
Well, what's she doing now?
Why, it looks like she's putting her hand on her heart, and then she's falling to the bed.
Oh no, what's wrong with her?
The crystal's gone dark, I can't tell.
You don't suppose she could be sick, do you? I'm ready to home to her right away.
Well, aren't you going with me?
Oh, no, I have to get to her right away. Goodbye, Professor Marvel, and thanks a lot.
Goodbye. Safe journey. Better get this stuff under cover. Looks like it's going to be a storm. Poor kid. Hope she makes it home okay.
Thank you.
Gale from Kansas.
Oh, well, is that the witch?
Toto? Well, Toto's my dog.
Well, I'm a little muddled. The Munchkins called me because a new witch has just dropped a house on the Wicked Witch of the East. And there's the house. And here you are. And those lights are all that's left of the Wicked Witch of the East. And so, what the Munchkins want to know is, are you a good witch or a bad witch?
But I've already told you, I'm not a witch at all. Witches are old and ugly.
What was that? The Munchkins. They're laughing because I am a witch. I'm Glinda, the Witch of the North.
You are? I beg your pardon, but I've never heard of a beautiful witch before.
Only bad witches are ugly. The Munchkins are happy because you have freed them from the Wicked Witch of the East.
Oh, but if you please, what are Munchkins?
The little people who live in this land. This is Munchkin Land, and you are their national heroine, my dear. It's all right. You may all get up and thank her.
Come out, wherever you are, and meet the young lady who fell from a star. She fell from the sky, she fell very far, and Kansas, she says, is the name of the star.
Kansas, she says, is the name of the star.
She brings you good news, or haven't you heard, when she a miracle occurred.
It really was no miracle. What happened was just this. The wind began to switch, the house to pitch, and suddenly the hinges started to unhitch. Just then, the witch, to satisfy an itch, went flying on a broomstick, thumbing for a hitch.
Get you in the light.
house. Under the house?
I'm so sorry. It's my fault. My house dropped on her.
You dropped your house on my sister? How can anyone be so unbelievably clumsy?
Closer?
You recognize her then? Of course I recognize her! Who else would wear ruby slippers with those? Stop! Little girl, you've done me a service. Now I shall don the ruby slippers, which will make my power greater than ever! The slippers! They're gone! The slippers! What did you do with them?
See for yourself. Step forward, Dorothy.
You just better be around
too late. There they are, and there they'll stay.
Give them back to me. They're of no use to you. I'm the only one who knows how to use them. Give them to me. Give them back to me!
Keep tight inside of them. Their magic must be very powerful, or she wouldn't want them so badly.
Yes, yes, Linda, or I'll fix you as well.
Oh, fiddle-faddle, you have no power wand here. Be gone before somebody drops a house on you, too.
Very well. I'll bide my time. But as for you, my fine lady, true, I can't attend to you here now if I would like. But after a beautiful period of mourning, I'll have my revenge. And those ruby slippers, too. So just try and stay out of my way. Just try. I'll get you, my pretty, and your little dog, too.
You're off to see the wizard, the wonderful
go.
Pardon me, that way's a very nice way.
Who said that? Well, don't be silly, Toto. Scarecrows don't talk.
It's pleasant down that way, too.
That's funny. Wasn't he pointing the other way?
Of course, people do go both ways.
Why? You did say something, didn't you? Are you doing that on purpose? Or can't you make up your mind?
Well, that's just it. I am not a mind. I am a good brain, only straw.
Well, how can you talk if you haven't got a brain?
I don't know. But some people without brains do an awful lot of talking, don't they?
Yes, I guess you're right. Well, can't you get down?
Well, down? Oh, no. You see, I've got this pole stuck up my back.
Well, can I help you?
Oh, well, of course, I'm not very bright about doing things, but if you'll just bend the nail down to the back, maybe I'll slip off.
Well, I'll certainly try. It's an awfully stiff nail.
Oh, hey, hold some of me again.
Does it hurt you?
Oh, no, I just keep picking it up and putting it back in. Oh, my, it's going to be free. Oh. Oh. Did I scare you?
Well, no, I just thought you hurt yourself.
But I didn't scare you?
Well, of course not.
Didn't think so. You see, I can't even scare a crow.
Housekeeper.
They come from miles around to feed in my field.
Howdy, scarecrow.
You laugh in my face. Said a scarecrow swinging on a pole to a blackbird sitting on a feather stool. Oh, Lord, give me a soul, but forgot to give me a sense. If I had an ounce of common sense, I'd
have
to wildly cut out the perfect little lovers. It's only a dream. And my head, I can stretch it while my thoughts are busy quenching it by me to tell you. I unravel every riddle for every individual in trouble or in pain. If I only had a brain. Oh, I can tell you why. The ocean's near the shore.
You could think of things you never thought before.
And then I'd sit and think some more. I would not be just nothing. My head all full of stuff. My heart all full of pain. I'd dance and dance, I would be a demon there if I would have a brain. Oh, I can tell you why. The ocean's near the shore. I could think of things I never thought before.
And then he'd sit and think some more.
Gosh, it would be awful pleasing to reason out the reason. The things I can't explain. Then perhaps I deserve ya, and be even worthy of ya.
Oh.
If I had a brain. If I only had a brain.
Kansas could do that. Why, the crows would be scared to pieces.
They would?
Oh, yes.
What? Where's Kansas?
Well, it's where I live. And I want to get back home so badly, I'm going all the way to get the Wizard of Oz to help me.
You're going to see a wizard?
Uh-huh.
Oh, do you think if you took me with you, this wizard might give me some brains?
I couldn't say. But even if you didn't, you'd be no worse off than you are now.
Well, yes, that's true.
But maybe you better not. I've got a witch man at me, and you might get in trouble.
A witch, huh? I ain't afraid of no witch. I ain't afraid of anything. Well, except the lightning match.
Well, I don't blame you for that.
Oh, but I face the whole boss just for a chance to give me some brains. I won't be in trouble because I don't even think. And I won't turn to man to think. Well, I can't think. Well, won't you take me with you?
Why, of course I
do. Oh, brain! I'm going to give me a brain. Oh, let's go.
Oh. Oh. Well, you're not starting off very well.
Oh, I'll try. Really, I will.
To Oz?
To Oz.
We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful wizard of Oz. Here he is, a wizard of Oz, if ever a wizard there was.
If ever, ever a wizard was, a wizard of Oz is one
because.
Because of the wonderful things he does.
We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful wizard of Oz.
A man made out of tin.
What?
Yes, come look.
Oh!
Did that hurt?
No. It felt wonderful. I've been holding that axe up for ages.
My goodness, how did you ever get like this?
Well, when I was a flesh and blood like you, I fell in love with a munchkin whose mother hated me. So to keep me from marrying her daughter, she hired a wicked witch of the West to put a spell on my axe. When I went to chop down the tree, chopped off my leg instead.
Chopped your leg off?
That's terrible.
But by good fortune, I knew of a wonderful tinsman, and he made me a new leg, just as good as the old one. So back I went to work, and you know what happened?
Well, something terrible like that.
I swung my axe. Dang me if it didn't take off my other leg.
Well, you should have got a new axe.
Well, I suppose you're right. But I got me a new leg instead. And back I went to work.
You sure were persistent.
This time, I chopped off both my arms.
Oh. Well, now I can see how you could have chopped one of them off, but how did you manage to chop them both?
Well, I told you, the axe was enchanted.
Oh, see, Dorothy, if I had a brain, I could have figured that out for myself.
Sometimes I wish I hadn't gotten a new pair of arms from the tinsmith. The last time I swung my axe was the worst of all.
Oh, I don't want to hear this.
What happened?
I split myself right down the middle.
Oh.
So I went home, and they gave me a new hat and a new button. So I got caught in a terrible rainstorm on my way home. I've been here ever since.
Well, it just wasn't your day, was it?
Well, you're perfect now.
My neck. Well, perfect. Just bang on my chest if you think I'm perfect. Go ahead. Bang on it.
Beautiful. What an echo.
It's empty. The tinsmith forgot to give me a paw.
No heart?
No paw. Oh. As long as I have no heart, I can never love my munchkin maid.
Well, don't cry, Tin Man. You'll rust again.
I used to call her name on every tree.
You can say that again.
Said a tin man, rattling his gears to a straw man's sad, weary eye.
Oh, the smith gave meat and ribs, but forgot to put a heart to the side.
Then he banged his hollow chest and cried.
When the man's an empty kettle, he should be on his mantle, and yet I'm torn apart. Just because I'm presuming that I could be kind of human if I only had a heart. I'd be tender, I'd be gentle, and often sentimental regarding love and art. I'd be friends with the sparrows and the boy who shoots the arrows if I only had a heart. Picture me a balcony above the voice sings low.
Wherefore art thou, Romeo?
I hear a beat,
how sweet,
just to register emotion, jealousy, devotion, and really feel the part. I can say young and chipper, and I lock it with a zipper in my own.
Hey!
back to the tinsmith and ask him to give you a new heart.
Oh, he went out of business long ago.
Ran out of tin.
Oh. Well, then why don't you come with us? We're on our way to the Emerald City now, and you can ask the Wizard of Oz for a heart.
Well, suppose he wouldn't give me one when we got there.
But he will. He must. We've come such a long way already.
You call that love? Why, you only just mean us.
You're the one who put the spell on my axe.
Well, it certainly chopped you down to size, didn't it? And now you're helping a fine lady along, my good gentleman. Well, stay away from her! Or I'll stop a mattress with you, Scarecrow! And you, Tin Man, I'll use you for a beehive!
Well, I'm not afraid of you!
That just proves you don't have a brain. Allow me to educate you. Here, Scarecrow, wanna play ball?
Fire!
Just remember, Scarecrow, helping that little girl reach the Emerald City could be your last burning ambition!
Well, I'm still not afraid of her. I'll see you get to the Emerald City, whether I get a brain or not. Stop the mattress with me. Well, I'll see you get to the Emerald City, whether I get a bug or not. Beehive, bah! Let him try and make a beehive out of me.
Well, you're the best friends anybody ever had. I know it's funny, but I feel that I've known you all the time. But I couldn't have, could I?
Oh, I don't see how. You weren't around when I was stuffed and sewn together.
And I was standing over there rusting for the longest time.
Still, I wish I could remember. But it doesn't really matter. We all know each other now, don't we?
That's right, we do. To Oz.
We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz. We hear he is the wizard of Oz, and never a wizard of Oz. It's a wizard of Oz, is one who wins. Because
of the wonderful things he does.
We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz.
The wild forest.
If I lived there, I'd be petrified.
Look, you lopsided bag of hay.
Well, I'll get you anyway, Pee-wee!
Shame on you! No, but you tried to. It's bad enough picking on a strong man, but when you go around picking on poor little dogs...
Oh, you're not gonna hit me. Get my nose, please.
Well, of course not. What a fuss you're making. Naturally, when you go around picking on things weaker than you are. Why, you're nothing but a great, big coward.
Oh, you're right. I am a coward. I am a coward. I even scare myself. I haven't slept a wink. Look at the circles under my eyes.
Well, why don't you try counting sheep?
That doesn't do any good. I'm afraid of them.
That's too bad. Don't you think the wizard could help him too?
Well, I don't see why not. Why don't you come with us? We're on our way to see the wizard now to get him a heart.
And him a brain.
I'm sure that he'd give me some courage.
Well, won't you feel the great beast in the company of a cowardly lion? I would.
Of course not.
Gee, that's awfully nice of you. My life's simply been unbearable. Even my family's gone when I was just a little cub. My father took me atop of a high mountain, waved his paws, and said, "Son, one day all this will be yours." I was terrified.
Well, why is that?
I'm afraid I'm late.
Don't worry, Lion. The wizard will fix everything.
Well, at least you'll be safe if I come with you.
How's that?
No self-respecting wild animal will come anywhere near me.
Life is said, believe me, Missy, when you're born to be a sissy without the name and boy. Boy, I'd like to change my habits never more, be scared of rabbits if I only had the noise. I'm afraid there's no denying, I'm just a dandelion, a pain I don't deserve. Boy, I could show my props, be a lion, cat or mouse, if I only had the noise.
Oh, you would be in your stride, a king down to the core.
You can roar the way you've never roared before.
And then I'd roar, and roar some more.
I would show the dinosaurs,
who's king around the forest.
A king they better soy. Why would I regal means or I would be another Caesar if I only had the noise? I'd be brave as a blizzard,
I'd be gentle as a lizard, I'd be clever as a gizzard.
Yes, the wizard is a wizard who will serve.
Then I'm sure to get a brain, a heart,
a home,
the noise.
But messy. So many and creative wins the day! I will put them to sleep forever.
And the ruby slippers will be mine!
Hold on to your breath, hold on to your heart, hold on to your flow. No more. on my face. It's a... Just a minute.
Bell has an order. Please knock.
Well, that's more like it. Now, state your business.
We want to see the wizard.
The wizard? But nobody can get in to see the Great Oz. Nobody's ever seen the Great Oz. Even I've never seen it.
Then how do you know there is one?
Because... because... Well, if it wasn't real, why would you be here?
Well, please, sir, please. I've got to see the wizard. The good witch in the north sent me.
Prove it!
What? She's wearing the ruby slippers she gave her.
Well, bust my buttons. That's a horse of a different color.
Hey, who's he called a horse? Why, if he wasn't on that side.
But he's come out.
He's be on this side.
Welcome to Emerald City. Every step is worth it, believe me. Have you any idea just how wonderful this place really is?
Well, I've been trying to imagine it, but I haven't had a break. They told me I'm all alone. If I only had a heart.
It's the only place I don't need anything harder. Because there's nothing to scare. Instead.
There's a garden spot I told where it's never too hot and it's never too
and too young, and too old, where you'll never see thin or tall, and you'll never, never do anything at all.
It's all true. Oh, we're not too mad, and we're not too sane, and we don't come here, and we don't complain. All we do is just sit tight. Cause it's all so, so, so downright right.
Thank you.
the Great Oz, not no bunny, not no hop.
Oh, but you said you'd take us to him.
I got a permanent, just for the occasion.
Not no bunny, not no hop.
Well, you just gotta make him see Dorothy.
Dorothy? Did you say Dorothy? The witch's Dorothy?
In person.
Well, that makes a difference. I'll announce you at once.
Hear that? He'll announce us at once. I've as good as got my breath. I can barely hear my heart beating.
I'll be home in time for supper.
In another hour, I'll be king of the forest. Long live the king. My regal robes of the forest
would be satin, not cotton,
not chintz. I'd command each thing, be it fish or fowl, in a royal crown. As I click my heel, all the dreams would kneel, and the mountains bow. And the bulls go bow, and the sparrows they would take wing. If I were king, each rabbit would show respect to me. The gym would genuine. To me, though my tail were lush, I would show compassion for every hunter. If I were king, just king.
cry, Dorothy. We'll get you to see the wizard somehow.
Annie was so good to me. I never appreciated it. Running away and hurting her feelings. Professor Marvel says she's sick. She may be dying. It's all my fault. I'll never forgive myself. Never, never, never.
Oh, don't cry anymore. I'll get you in to see the wizard somehow.
Oh, thank you.
It's all right. I knew an answer myself once.
Where's it going?
I'm gonna get home. Oh, you're brave.
This way. Step on up. The wizard awaits you.
Wait a minute, folks. I was just thinking. I really don't want to see the wizard.
Why not? The wizard is going to give you some courage.
I've been too afraid to ask for it.
Oh, come on, Lion. We'll be scared together.
Okay. What? Somebody just pulled my tail.
Well, you did it yourself.
Oh, I'm such a butterfly. Oh, I don't like the sounds. Dumbledore's over! Dumbledore's over! The witch of the west.
But to do that, we'd have to kill her to get it.
Bring me her broomstick, and I'll grant your request. Now go.
But what if she kills us first?
I said go.
Oh, say no more. I'm already gone.
What does it mean?
anyway?
You mean, you'll be home.
Yes. The words mean anything.
Well, it's an old Minky Martian song meaning roughly,
yo-hee-ho,
whoa!
Oh, Scarecrow, that's you all over.
The time you forced yourself together, I would, but I can't reach my legs.
Oh, yeah. Oh, here's your arm. And then we'll go rescue Dorothy.
Oh, that's right. And the lion believes.
Yeah.
Wait, me?
Yes,
you. I'm going to lead us against the forces of evil?
That's right.
Oh, okay. I'll do it for Dorothy. Wicked witch, and no wicked witch. Gods, no gods. I'll tear them apart. I may not come out alive, but I'm going in faking. There's only one thing I want you fellas to do.
What's that?
Talk me out of it. No!
I say, what do you say, Toto? uniforms, whoever can find those.
Fellas!
Oh, I don't know, the whole planet.
Fellas, three winky uniforms.
Fellas, we gotta have four cops.
Why is that? They're right behind us.
Scarecrow, you're all burned up!
No!
What? I
this? The witch's brew. May we have it?
Oh, yes, please, here, take it with you.
Oh, thank you. Now we can go back to the wizard and tell him that the wicked witch is dead.
The wicked witch is dead!
The wicked witch is dead. Witch, oh, witch, the wicked witch.
I'm speechless.
And
And as for you, my galvanized friend, why, you desire a heart. You have no idea how lucky you are not to have a heart. For hearts will never be practical until they're made unbreakable.
But I still want one.
Back where I come from, we have people that do good deeds for others all day long. They're called they're called good deed doers. And they have no more heart than you do. But the one thing they have that you don't have is a testimony. So in recognition of your kindness to others, I take great pride in bestowing upon you a small token of our esteem and affection. Wear it with honor. And remember, my sentimental friend, that a heart is not judged by how much you love others, but by how much others love you in return.
Well, listen, it ticks, it ticks!
A brief one I've never sensed.
What about Dorothy?
Yeah.
Ah, Dorothy.
Dorothy next!
Well, I don't think there's anything you meant back to me.
Well, my dear Dorothy, you forced me to a cataclysmic decision. The way to get you back to Kansas is for me to take you there myself.
Oh, will you? Could you? Oh, but are you a clever enough wizard to manage me?
My dear child, you cut me to the quick. Well, I'm an old Kansas man myself. Balloonist par excellence for the Miracle Wonderland's Carnival Company, where, while performing feats of the stratospheric kind never before attempted by humankind, the balloon failed to return to the fair.
It did?
Were you frightened?
Frightened? While you're looking at a man who has laughed at the face of death, chuckled at catastrophe, and snickered at doom. Frightened? I was petrified. But the balloon, the wind changed, and the balloon dropped down in the heart of this noble land, where I was instantly declared Oz, the first Wizard Deluxe.
Deluxe, from the French, taking the luxury!
Well, yes, there are a few luxuries that went with the job, but I took it anyway, retaining the balloon for the advent of a quick escape. And in that balloon, my dear Dorothy, we will go back to the land of E. Pluribus Unum. Step this way. Citizens of Oz, I, your wizards, are Ardua and Elta. I'm about to embark on a dangerous and technically unexplainable journey into the outer stratosphere. To confer, converse, and otherwise hobnob with my fellow wizards. And until that time that I return, if any, Scarecrow, by virtue of his highly intelligent brain, shall rule in my stead, assisted by the Tin Man, by virtue of his loving heart, and the Lion, by virtue of his magnificent courage.
Yes.
Obey them as you would obey me. Balloon is now set, dear Dorothy. The wind is ready, so climb aboard.
Climb aboard, Missy, while the wind's in your favor.
Well, where's Toto? I can't go without him.
I'll get him.
But wait, don't let go of the rope!
What?
This is a highly irregular procedure!
The balloon's going up!
Oh, Professor, don't go without me!
Absolutely unprecedented!
Oh, please, Professor, you can't go!
I can't come back!
Get your dog!
Never, never, never.
helped any longer, you've always had the power to go back to Kansas.
I have?
Well, why didn't you tell us sooner?
Because she wouldn't have believed me. She had to learn for herself.
What have you learned, Dorothy?
Well, I think that it wasn't enough just to want to see Uncle Henry and Aunt Anne again. And if I ever go searching for my own heart's desire again, I won't look any further than my own backyard. Because if it wasn't there, I never really lost it to begin with. Is that right?
That's all it is.
Oh, but that's so easy. I should have thought of it before.
I should have felt it in my heart. Me too. If I had encouraged my convictions.
No, she had to learn for herself. Now those magic slippers will take you back to Kansas in 2 seconds.
Well, Toto 2.
Toto 2.
Oh, that's so wonderful. It's gonna be so hard to say goodbye. I love you all. Goodbye to me. Oh, don't cry. You'll rest so dreadfully.
Now I know I've got a thought. Because it's breaking me.
Goodbye, Lion.
I know it isn't right, but I'm going to miss the way you used to holler for help before you found your courage.
I think when you're gone, I'm going to do a little more hollering.
Oh, dear Scarecrow. No more first friend here. I think maybe I'll miss you most of all.
Having a brain don't make parting any easier, Dorothy. I'll think of you. Always.
Are you ready now?
Say goodbye, Toto. Yes. Before I change my mind and stay here forever.
Then close your eyes and tap your heels together 3 times. And think to yourself over and over. There's no place like home. There's no place like home.
There's no place like home.
1.
There's no place like home.
2.
There's no place like home.
Goodbye, Dorothy.
Could you?
Oh, of course not. But where's Scarecrow?
Scarecrow?
Who the heck's Scarecrow?
Oh, there you are.
How's she doing?
She'll be fine.
You lost all your stuffing.
Stuffing?
What'll happen to the field mouse you had in your stomach?
A field mouse? You gave me more than one of them in there. I had a whole thing of butterflies.
Dorothy!
Annie M.
Oh, Dorothy, you're safe and well.
Annie M, where are my slippers?
Why,
I wouldn't
miss
a slipper on you, honey. You haven't done anything wrong.
You don't understand. This was a real, truly life place. I remember this moment, it wasn't very nice. But most of it was beautiful. And you were all there. You kept rusting off. You kept pulling your own tail. And you were a humbug.
Hey, let's not get personal now.
Doesn't anybody believe me?
Well, of course we believe you. Now let's get you back into bed.
Has the house come back? They found the witch, you know.
Oh no, the storm passed right by.
And it wasn't a house that fell in Miss Gulch.
It was a tower for after all.
We won't be hearing from Batman until our leg gets out of plaster.
Well, that Toto's safe. And we're home. You hear that, Toto? We're home. And you're all here. And I'm not gonna leave here ever, ever again. Because I love you all. And oh, Annie M, there really is no place like home.